we are starting with our chapter 9. We were discussing chapter 9 for a long time. Saisham, can you switch off your video? Yes, thank you. So we are discussing chapter 9. The chapter name is water. What is the chapter name, children? Water. So we were discussing about the essentials of water. Essential for our life. Water is essential for our life. All living things need water to live. So all the living things need water to live. We cannot live without water. Any living things cannot live without water. So we were even discussing about the uses of water. So who's going to tell me that? Yes. Yes, Adila. Tell me some of the uses of water.
Drinking, bathing, cleaning, house, cooking, planting.
Yes. Okay.
Water.
Okay, that's nice, Adila. That's nice. Thank you for answering. Very good. Next, I want Dinesha. Tell me some of the uses of water.
Drink. Bath.
Okay.
Wash.
Okay.
Washing vegetables. Washing clothes.
Okay.
Cook.
Okay.
Clean.
Okay.
Cleaning pet. Fishy. Water plant. Fishy.
Okay.
Putting out fire. Okay. Washing car. Swim. Mopping floors. Washing hands. Okay.
Yes, very good, Pranisha. That's really nice. So, what are the activities we do with water, children? We used to do like washing vegetables. We used to wash vegetables. We used to wash clothes, cooking, cleaning, and cleaning your pet, water, cleaning utensils, putting out fire, washing cars, swimming, mopping, and washing hands. So, this is the main activities what we do with using water. So these are the activities we do using water. Even there are more, some more activities we do with water. So I think these are the basics you have to know. So these are the basic activities you do using water. Next we saw about the sources of water. What we saw, children? We saw about the sources of water. So now, Sarvesh, tell me what is the main source of water. What is the main source of water?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the main source of water, dear?
The main source of water.
What is the main source of water?
Water in the plants.
Okay, that's our activity. Sarvesh, what is the main source? How we are getting water, dear? How we are getting water?
Warm.
What is this, Appu?
Rain.
This.
Yes. So what is the main source of water?
Warm.
Okay, so the main source of water is?
Rain.
The main source of water is? Rain. Yes. Very good. Very good, Sarvesh. So the main source of water is rain. So we have some more sources of water where the rainwater gets stuffed up. So we are going to see those sources. So what is the first? So okay, let me ask someone. Okay. Yes, Kevin. Tell me some of the sources of water.
mother.
Pond, lake, okay. River, stream.
Very good comment. That's really nice. So, Dhyani, tell me what are the sources of water?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell me the sources of water?
Sources of waters are puddles, pond, lake, river, stream.
Very good, Dhyani. That's really nice. So, what are the main source of water is rain. So, through rain, we have some more sources of water like puddle, pond, lake, river, and stream. What are the sources of water? Puddle, pond, lake, river, and stream. So these are the sources of water. We take out groundwater from some places. Am I right, children? So some water gets stuck up under the ground, on the ground. So we have to take those groundwater to get somewhere. So we can use it somewhere. So what are the other sources? How we are taking our groundwater? Who's going to tell me that? Akshaya. Yes, Akshaya. Tell me how, in what way you are using groundwater, in what way we are using groundwater?
Tap, well, and hand pump.
Okay. Then? That's it?
Tube well.
Okay. And one main thing, which is in your home? You forgot that. What is that? Yes, tap. Very good, Akshaya. Yes, very good, Akshaya. You got it. So, next is Akshara. Akshara, tell me how we are using groundwater. What are the ways we use groundwater? Using what we are using groundwater?
Well, tube well.
Yes.
Hand pump.
Okay.
Tap.
Very good. Very good, Akshaya. Excellent. That's awesome, dear. So, some of the water during rain, some of the water gets stuck up in ground. So, how we are using groundwater? In what are the ways we are using groundwater? The way of well, so the groundwater gets sucked up on the ground. So by well we are getting the groundwater. Tube well, I think most of you have, if you are in village, so you might have seen this. Tube well, have seen it. Even well we have seen it. Next is hand pump. This is common somewhere. And the main thing is tap, which we are using now. So what are the ways? Well, tube well, hand pump, and tap. So what are the ways, children? Well, tube well, hand pump, and tap. So these are the ways where we feed through the ground. We got it, children? So next, we are going to see some of the properties of water. Yes, we did many experiments with this. So, who's going to tell me that? Varshita. Varshita, tell me the properties of water.
Colorless, tasteless, and odorless.
Okay. What is the second point?
Shape of content in which is purple.
Good, okay. What is the third one?
There were many things like stream, eater, tapper.
Okay, that's nice, Vashita. Okay, next is Bihar, tell me the properties of water.
Yes, ma'am.
What are the properties of water? What are the properties of water?
Water is colorless, tasteless, and odorless.
Very good.
Water has no shape.
Very good.
Water can store many things like two sugar and salt, etc.
Okay. That's excellent, Viha. You did a very good job. So, we are seeing the properties of water. So, first we saw we had a glass of water and we checked the color, taste and the smell. So, there is no color for the water, there is no taste for the water, and even there is no smell, that is odorless. So, what is the first property, children? You can repeat along with me. So, the water is colorless, tasteless and odorless. The water is colorless, tasteless and odorless. So, this is the first property. What is the second property, children? Water takes the shape of the container in which it is poured. In which it is poured. So, if you pour in a cup, if you pour some water, so it will be in the shape of the cup. If you pour the water in a bottle, so how it will be shaping, ma? So, it will be in the shape of bottle. So, if you are pouring some water in the jar, it will be in the shape of jar. So, there is no shape for the water. It takes the shape of the container in which it is poured. So, what is the second one? There is no shape for water. It takes the shape of the container in which it is poured. What is the third point, children? Water can dissolve many things. What is the third point, children? Water can dissolve many things. So, even we have did some experiments. So, what is the first one we did? So, we put some salt inside the water and we checked, the salt suddenly got disappeared. So, it's nothing but the salt got dissolved. Even we checked with the sugar, we were putting some sugar inside the glass of water. So, when we are mixing it, what happened, children? It got dissolved again, that is, got disappeared. So, these are the properties of water. Once again, I want one of you to tell the properties. Bryden, tell me the properties again, dear. What are the properties?
Colorless, tasteless, waterless, odorless. Odorless.
What is the second one?
Take the shape of the container.
Okay, what is the third one?
Salt and sugar dissolve the water and it disappears.
So, okay, if I'm putting some sand inside the water, what happens? What will happen, Bryden?
It will not dissolve anymore.
It will get dissolved. Have you seen? You get inside the water, right? Have you tried it? Have you tried it, Bryden? Okay, you try it and tell me. Okay, Bryden?
Okay,
I'll try.
Okay, that's really nice. So, whatever we put inside the water, it gets dissolved. Okay, thank you so much, Bryden. So, next we saw the topic, need for water. So, why we need to store water? Maha, tell me why we should save water, you should store water. Why we should do that, Ma? Maha? Okay, why we should store water? Why we have to store water?
We don't
Yes, Mahat, you were right. Can you be a little louder?
We don't have water in some area.
Okay. Okay, that's nice, Mahat. Okay, you tried well. That's nice. Thank you. I want one of you to tell me why we should store water. Alia, tell me why we should store water, Ma. Alia, why we should store water?
Ma'am.
Why we should store water?
Because we don't have water in some place.
Okay. Okay, have you been without water, Alia? Have you been without water?
No. No, ma'am.
No. Okay, so we are in some nice place because we have water 24 hours. That's nice, Alia. That's nice. Okay. Pavitra, tell me why we should store water. Pavitra! Tell me why we should store water. Pavitra?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, tell me why we should store water.
Sometimes don't have water.
Okay.
When we need water, our areas will be like that.
Okay. Okay, I will give you a scenario, Pavitra. So, how you will store water in your home? How you will store water in your home?
Tank.
Okay, in tank you will be storing your water. That's really nice. So,
yes.
Any other way?
Bucket.
Store water. Okay, bucket and so for drinking, where you will store water for drinking? So you will be having a small bottle, right? You will be having a bottle, right? For you?
Yes.
You have a pink color bottle, right? You have a pink color bottle and you will be storing water for you to drink. Am I right, Pavitra?
Yes.
Yes, very good. That's really nice, Pavitra. So need for storage of water. So this is the topic. So what we were discussing yesterday is, so in some places, I think you have seen some deserts like these places, right? So there, they won't be having that much of water. Here we have 24 hours of water. So we have water anytime, anywhere. Okay, so for them, there won't be any water. So what they will do is, they take a pot or some bucket or anything. So what they will do is, they have stored some water and they will take it from a longer distance. Because water won't be available in that place, at all the places. So what they will do is, they will be having some pots or anything. So what they will do, they will store some water and they will bringing it to their home. So they will be storing it for a longer time. So this is how they'll be doing. And we did even some emergency time. I told you, right, children? So if there is any power cut or any tube cut breakdown or anything, so at that time, what you will do, if you have stored the water, you can use it. Or else it will be very big in trouble, okay? So, sometimes the water supply gets disrupted in emergency. Yeah, as I told you, maybe the pipe breakage or power cut or anything. So, at that time, what you will do, so if you have stored the water, you can use it. If you have not stored your water, what will happen? there won't be any water and it will be a big trouble. So this is how we'll be doing it. And next, we saw some of the storage of water, like water can be stored in clean and closed containers like buckets, drums and tanks. So we have those things in our home. So what we will do usually, so we will be storing water inside the tank or a bucket or anything. So we'll be using it. Am I right, children? So I think most of you will have this kind of tank in your home. So this is how we have to store water. And also it should be closed so that it will be very clean or else it will be dirty enough. So close the water if you are getting stored. And also for drinking, you will be storing water in kuti kuti bottles you have in your home. So for drinking also you are storing water and you are using it. That's really nice. So this is the need for storage of water. Did you understand, children? Did you understand? Yes, I can see some answers. Tanusha, Dhyanesh. Yes, for future use. Very good, Dhyanesh. Yes, that's really nice. Very good, Dakshan. Very good, Saishan. That's really nice. Very good, children. Okay, I hope you all understood this lesson, this topic. Next, we are going to see the need for judicious use of water. Need for judicious use of water. So, we saw some topics. That first one is water is very precious. Okay, so we have to use it in a proper way. You children have told me that you'll be taking shower and you'll be wasting water and you'll be playing by using water, cleaning your toys and everything. So you should not waste the water. So what you have to do is you should save even a drop of water. So first point is water is precious. Repeat along with me, children. Water is precious. What is the first point? Water is precious. Can you tell me again? Water is precious. What is the second point, children? What is the second point? We have to save water. You should not waste it. Save water, don't waste it. We should save water and we should not waste it. So every single drop of water counts. So you should save the water. So what is the two points? Who's going to tell me the two points? The judicious use of water. Zain, tell me, what is the judicious use of water?
Water is precious.
Very good.
We should not waste water.
Very good, Zain. That's really nice. So, Zain, tell me, if your mom is wasting water by playing with toys or anything, if she is wasting the water, what you will say to her?
Do not waste water.
Yes, you should not waste water, Mama. It's very precious. Please don't waste the water. Even if she is opening the tap and if she is using it, please close it, okay? Okay, Zain? Okay, that's really nice, Zain. Yeah, welcome, dear. So that's really nice, Zain. You understood. I want one more to tell the judicious use of water. Who is going to tell me that? Samyukta. Samyukta, tell me the judicious use of water. What are the two points?
Water is precious. We not should waste water. We have to save water.
Very good, Samyukta. That's really nice. Okay, you tell me, if your father is playing in water, he's wasting a lot of water, what you will do?
I will say, don't waste water.
Wow, that's really nice, Samyukta. You children are so sweet. So, very good, Samyukta. Even everyone are really great. You children have understood the use of water, why we should save water. And now we are going to see the topic, how to save water. So we are going to see how we can save water. So yes ma'am, I have lot of water in my home, so how will I save it? So this is the question I think you all are asking me, I can hear that. So we are going to see how to save water. So the first point, fix the leakage. What is the first point? Fixing the leakage. If you have any leakage in your home, like even some of the pipes get loosen up, so at that time you have to fix it so that you cannot waste even a drop of water. So what is the first point, children? Fix the leakage. What is the first point? Fix the leakage. And what is the second point? Use mug to water plant. Okay, I've seen people using pipes, long pipes, and spraying water here and there like anything. So you should not do like that. So you can use a bucket and mug to water plants. So if you have garden, even if you have a small pot in your home, so what you can do is you can use a mug to water the plants. Okay, children, you can use a mug to water the plants. What is the third point? Turn off the faucet tightly. That is the tap tightly. So have you ever seen, children? There will be some drops getting down from the tap if you're not closed the tap properly. So I think you all have seen that. Yes, always turn off the faucet tightly after use. What you have to do? Always turn off the faucet or tap tightly after use so that you cannot waste even a drop of water. So use bucket to take bath. It's the main topic for all the children. So my dear children, what you have to do? You have to use bucket to take bath. I think most of the children will be switching on the shower and they'll be singing and they will be dancing in shower. So I think you should not do like that. It is also a kind of wasting of water. So what you have to do, children? You have to use a bucket to take bath. So this is the process how we can save water. Can we discuss it again? What is the first point, children? Fix the leakage. What is the first point? Fix the leakage. What is the second point, children? Use mug to water plants. Use mug to water plants. What is our third point? Turn off the faucet tightly. Turn off the faucet tightly. Use bucket to take bath. Use bucket to take bath. So these are the process how we can save water. So who's going to tell me the topics? I mean, who's going to tell me how to save water? Yokesh, can you tell me, dear? Tell me how to save water, Yokesh. How to come on, Yoki.
Fix the leakage.
Yokesh, come on. Ni good boy dana, sollu papo. How to save water? I thought you are a good boy, Yokesh. Yokesh, good boy dana.
Fix always.
Always.
Water plant. Okay, that's nice, Yokesh. Okay, fine. Oh, okay, ma'am. Thank you so much. Very good, Yokesh. You are trying really well. Thank you. Next is Tanusha. Tanusha, tell me how to save water. Tanusha, are you there, Tanusha?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, tell me how to save water. We have discussed some points, right? Tell me how to save water.
Okay.
Very good. Very good, Tanusha. Very good. That's really nice. So I want one more to tell the answer. Yes. Sarvesh, tell me the answer. How to save water?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, tell me how you will save water. Tell me.
Fix the leakage.
Okay.
What is the plan? With mug.
Very good.
Turn off the water tightly.
Okay.
Take bath. Using bucket.
Very good. Very good, Sarvesh. Okay, tell me, Sarvesh, you will take bath, right? You will take bath daily, right? Will you take bath daily?
Yes.
Sarvesh. Okay. So, how you will take bath? In bucket or in shower?
Bucket.
Yes, very good, Sarvesh. You are really smart. That's really nice. Thank you for answering. So I want one more, the last one, to tell me the point. Okay, Shan, can you tell me how you will save water?
Use bucket to take bath.
Okay.
Tap tightly.
Okay.
60 liquid.
Okay.
Yes. Use bucket to water plant.
Bucket and mug. Yes. He's right, actually. Okay. Very good, Chan. That's really great. Very good. So, how we will save water, children? Once again, we can recap it. Fix the leakage. What you will do? Fix the leakage. Then use bucket or mug to water plants. You have to use bucket or mug to water plants. So you should not use the pipe to water plants and even watering your house, whole house using the pipe. You should not do that. So you have to use mug or bucket to water plants. Third one is turn off the faucet tightly. Turn off the faucet tightly. Very good, children. And the last one is use bucket to take bath. Use bucket to take bath. I think you all got it. So next, we are going to see how to reuse of water in the family. Next, what we are going to do, children? We are going to see how to use the water. Can we see, children? So, like, we must save water whenever it is possible. Yes, you have to save the water whenever it is possible. If there is any possibility to save the water, what you have to do? You have to save it. So, you should not waste it. So, we can also save water by reusing. Even if there are possibilities, you can reuse the water even after getting used. So that is called reuse. So what is reuse, children? You can use it twice or thrice. Yes. You can reuse the water. If you are washing clothes or anything, what you can do? So you can use it for washing cars. So what you can do? If you are washing clothes, you can use the same water to wash your car. So it is like a reuse. And even you water used for washing vegetables. So, if you are washing fruits and vegetables, what you have to do, you can use the water to plants. Yes, you can use the water to plants. So, you can water it. So, whatever the water you are using to wash fruits and vegetables, the same water can be used to water the plants. Okay, children? So, reuse aquarium water by cleaning purposes. So even they have told that reuse aquarium water for cleaning purposes. They even use the same water like they'll be using it for cleaning purposes. So how you can reuse the water? The first one is you can use the water which you are using it for washing clothes, those water can be used to wash cars. So because washing clothes, the water you're using for washing clothes will not be used for drinking. So you can use it for other purposes. So what you can do is, the washing clothes water, the whatever you are using for washing clothes can be used for the car wash. What is the second point, children? What you can do is, so whatever the water you are using to wash fruits and vegetables can be used to water plants. So these are the some of the way you can reuse. Even if you have any ideas, you can share me also. So these are the ways, the basic ways where we can reuse the water. So who is going to tell me the reuse of water? Pranisha, tell me how we can reuse the water.
You can use the water to cleaning clothes, to clean the car.
So, okay, the water which is used for washing clothes can be used to wash car. Very good, Pranisha. What is the second point? Pranisha, are you there?
The vegetable water to water plants.
Very good, Pranisha. That's really nice. So I want one more to answer it. Who's going to answer that? Dhyanesh. Yes, Dhyanesh.
Yes.
Tell me
yes,
how
ma'am.
We can reuse water.
Washing clothes to wash car. Wash.
Okay. Then.
Washing fruits and vegetable water the plants.
Okay, the water which we are using to wash fruits and vegetables, we can use the water to water plants. Very good, Dhyanesh. That's really nice. So I think you children have got it. One more, the last one, Bryden. Bryden, tell me how you will be using the water. Bryden, how you will reuse the water? How you will reuse the water, dear?
Water that's used for fruits and vegetables can be used to water the plants.
Very good. Very good, dear. Thank you. Okay, very good. So next is Adila. Adila, tell me how you will use the water.
After washing the clothes, washing the car, planting, water, washing the vegetables, plants.
Okay, very good, Adila. That's really nice. So thank you so much for answering. So I have a video for you all. So get ready for the video.
Thank you.
tell me whether you can hear or not. Can you hear it, children? Just type it. No, no. Okay. Oh, you cannot hear it?